So, dear attendees of the 6th Indian Pharmaceutical Forum, I'm delighted to be invited by the organizers of the conference to present to you today on the topic of environment and the microbial resistance and the industry-driven actions to address these concerns by the European manufacturers or marketing authorization holders. Let me move to the next slide, please. As announced, my name is Koen Lane, and I'm the Senior Quality and Regulatory Affairs Manager at Medicines for Europe. Medicines for Europe is the European association representing the European manufacturers of generic, biosimilars, and value-added medicines. Can I have the next slide, please? From these three sector groups of the association, Medicines for Europe has a vision to provide sustainable access to high-quality medicines. Related to quality of medicines, the reduction of the environmental concerns like manufacturing effluents, carbon dioxide, climate neutrality, and the green manufacturing play more and more a role as an important definition of what is a high-quality medicine, especially through the eyes of some external stakeholders, patients, regulators, and policymakers. Of course, these high-quality medicines need to be continued produced in a sustainable environment to ensure the availability of the product towards the patients. This brings us to the mission of our association, to increase access to medicines and drive improved health outcomes. Via all our members, we have a collective expertise in off-patent medicines, which have been proven clinically useful over the past years, and are effective in the majority of the population, and are the product of our members contributing to the market dynamics of availability for European patients. Next slide, please. Over the past years, it has become clear that the topics of pharmaceuticals and environment is on the agenda of European policymakers, regulators, and payers. European Health Action Plan against AMR was published some years ago. The pharmaceutical strategy, as published end 2020, explicitly contains ambitions towards environmental friendly manufacturing, less exposure of pharmaceutical environment, green manufacturing, which is also reflected in the Green Deal with the ambition of Europe to become climate neutral by 2050. The European Commission published 2 years ago the strategy on pharmaceuticals into environment, which will gradually result into legislative actions in the upcoming years. Related to the environment risk assessment, the current guidance is already dating back to 2006. Hence, the European Medicine Agency published a draft update regarding the environmental risk assessments to be conducted by marketing authorization holders and submitted together with the marketing authorization application. Also from the payer side, we see initiatives to include environmental aspects in the award criteria for tenders. If this drives the winning criteria away from the lowest price, this could differentiate between the different suppliers in a positive way. But the increased expenditures related to the environment should be rewarded and recognized by the payers. Defining such criteria should be done at European level and not at member state level or even local regional level to prevent different set of expectations to be developed, as this can also cause a huge administrative burden to supply the relevant documentation on the environmental compliance towards the tendering issuing bodies. Can I have the next slide, please? Pharmaceuticals in environment is a very complex issue, addressing multiple factors on how pharmaceuticals can end up in the environment and will not have a single solution to address these concerns. When tackling pharmaceuticals in environment, policymakers and regulators will need to keep in mind the risk of a potential exposure towards the environment. Pharmaceutical industry and academic world have provided multiple data sets and publications on pharmaceuticals to prevent the need for a blanket approach to address the issue, but to keep in mind, besides the potential risk, also the science behind the problem. A problem in the discussion is the limited information sharing and cooperation throughout the pharmaceuticals and environment chain. Here, there is definitely need for discussions and alignment to find a mutual agreed approach. It is clear that new legislation on pharmaceuticals and environment is coming, not only in Europe, but also in the rest of the world, including India. 1 year ago, a list of AMR-related manufacturing emission specification and sampling conditions was published by the Indian regulator. These emission specifications were much stricter compared to the risk-based derived targets as set for by the AMR Industry Alliance. I will come back on the Industry Alliance in the later slides. At this moment, the measurement systems for the pharmaceuticals and environment effects are compliant to the current legislation, but they will not be future-proof. Industry is concerned about the non-harmonized approach to address pharmaceuticals and environment, and different expectations might come from different regions in the world, while pharmaceuticals and environment and AMR are of global concern. Can I have the next slide? Before we move to the overview of the industry-driven initiatives around pharmaceuticals and environment, let me first elaborate a bit on a high level towards the different aspects on how the pharmaceuticals can end up in the environment. This is a point of view from the human medicinal products, while the veterinary consumption of high-risk molecules like antibiotics is much higher, and hence also the risk of these pharmaceuticals ending up into the environment. Looking at the three main pathways on pharmaceuticals in environment, the biggest portion is coming from the use of medicines and excretion of residues and metabolites by patients. This would contribute about 88%. Lower in risk would be the improper disposal of unused or expired medicines, which is about 10%. The lowest contributing factor, but in the eye of the public of big concern, is the 2% coming from manufacturing effluents. Can I have the next slide? It's still on the previous slide, but the last two routes of concern, the whole pharma industry is collaborating. So irrespective of the nature of the business, OTC, Rx, and generics, these collective actions will be highlighted in the next slides. So we come to this slide. So to address the concern in Europe on improper disposal and hence contribution to about 10% of pharmaceuticals in environment, industry in Europe has developed the Meds Disposal Campaign. It is a campaign to raise awareness on how to dispose of unused or expired medicines appropriately in Europe, bringing the information on the current disposal schemes in European countries to one online place. Via an interactive map, the exact details per country is listed on how to dispose of unused or expired medicines. This project is a low-hanging fruit which could solve already 10% of pharmaceuticals in the environment with limited efforts. Further knowledge and awareness obviously needs to be created towards the general public. Can I have the next slide? The next issue where the industry can play a direct role and to take ownership would be the manufacturing effluents management. Although only addressing 2% of the overall risk, from public perspective, has always been a very important issue to be addressed by industry. The general public and specific stakeholders are continuously raising this concern via different reports and publications. These reports include manufacturing discharge as a pollution and also AMR as a risk. Can I have the next slide? As we've seen on this slide, the topic continues to be in the spotlight. It also triggers the attention of global policymakers, regulators, and they're calling industry for actions. So going to the next slide, please. What is the industry doing now to address the concern of pharmaceuticals and environment? As mentioned earlier, all needs to be seen from a risk-based perspective. Antimicrobial resistance is rightly considered as a potential global risk, again, with many different facets to be addressed. For this reason, the industry aligned and formed the AMR Industry Alliance. In 2016, several manufacturers with the alliance committed to take actions to help addressing the risk of AMR. Initially, the alliance consisted of 13 primarily, but not exclusively, large R&D pharma companies with antibiotic research. The alliance expanded to include more generic companies in 2018, and even the years beyond, more and more generic companies joined the alliance. But also in 2021 and afterwards, the alliance is looking to attract more generic manufacturers as member of the industry alliance. In 2019, Medicines for Europe made the manufacturing commitments of the alliance for all our member associations a condition to become or to remain a member of, of Medicines for Europe. This is considered by our membership to be a very important step to combat AMR, as the majority of the produced and supplied antibiotics are off-patent, and our members would supply about 80% of all the antibiotics for European patients. Can I have the next slide, please? So now, what is the alliance standing for and what do they commit? They successfully developed and published in 2018 a common antibiotic manufacturing framework, giving details on the expectations which an antibiotic manufacturer should comply with respect to antibiotics manufacturing. The alliance also established a method to generate the predicted no effect concentrations, or PNECs, and the alliance developed a practical mechanism to transparently demonstrate that the supply chains meet the standards in the framework. This is performed via survey and a publication of a progress report every 2 years. Can I have the next slide? So from the AMR Industry Alliance side, the members should review their own manufacturing and supply chains to assess good practices in controlling release of antibiotics into the environment. They establish a common framework for managing antibiotics discharge, building on existing work such as the Pharmaceutical Supply Chain Initiative, and to start apply it across their own manufacturing and supply chains. They also will work with stakeholders to develop the practical mechanism to transparently demonstrate that these supply chains meet the standards in the framework. And they work with independent technical experts to establish science-driven but risk-based targets for the discharge concentrations. On the website of the Alliance, a booklet of the antibiotics manufacturing framework can be downloaded. Each company can use this to perform a self-assessment. Also, the list of the PNECs is publicly available and can be used to monitor your own progress to meet the industry targets. Can I have the next slide? Each 2 years, the AMR Industry Alliance is publishing a progress report where the different insights towards the different working pillars of the Alliance are provided. These pillars are access, appropriate use, R&D, and manufacturing. Especially towards the manufacturing pillar, I would like to indicate the fact that based on the 2019 collected information, the generic sector still had to perform the analysis of the readiness by the external suppliers, which meet the framework. At that point in time, only 7% of the external suppliers have been assessed. I must also add that also the internal manufacturing sites, for this the assessment would be far off from reaching the 100% target. As AMR is key on the agenda, the new progress report for 2022, for which the data will be collected as of Q2 this year by the Industry Alliance members, will definitely look towards an increase in the assessment of the external suppliers. So this could also be your company. Hence, a warm welcome and invite to look at the framework and the PNECs as published on the Alliance on their website. Can I have the next slide? As the manufacturing framework and the PNECs are good initiatives which the industry believes they should become globally recognized targets for antibiotics manufacturing, the Industry Alliance started to engage with the British Standards Institute to develop by the end of this year a public available specification, which is a consensus standard based on the Alliance framework and the PNECs. And then later on, by 2022, BSI would then develop a certification scheme which would allow companies to get certification for their products. This should be possible as of 2023. Can I have the next slide? The publicly available specification and certification scheme will be an opportunity for greater assurance and transparency towards buyers and stakeholders of antibiotics, and also meeting environmental responsible manufacturing processes through an independent third-party certification. Besides the greater assurance and transparency for the buyers and the stakeholders, it will also ensure a streamlined risk assessment approach for suppliers and customers, and to bring a uniform and standardized solution, irrespective of the location of your production. The publicly available specification or standard would define methodologies and protocols for auditing antibiotics manufacturing processes within a manufacturing facility. And these would be based on the existing AMR Industry Alliance manufacturing framework and the PNEX. The British Standard Institute was chosen because it has a high it is a highly respected organization for and which is known for the expertise into standard development and third-party certification. Can I go to the next slide? What about now towards other medicinal products besides antibiotics? Medicines play a critical role in ensuring high level of public health, and we believe that political debates on pharmaceuticals and environment should not overlook the value that medicines bring towards the citizens. As pharmaceuticals can enter the environment at all stages of the product's life cycle, reducing pharmaceuticals and environment will be a result of a cooperation between public, private sector, but also the consumers they serve. Therefore, all the actions strike to an optimal balance between economic cost and the benefits of medicines towards the public health. Environmental concerns should not be overshadowed by public health benefits. This principle is very much part of the Eco-Pharmaco Stewardship Project, which has been developed by the European pharmaceutical manufacturers. Can I go to the next slide? The objective of this industry task force on eco-pharmaco stewardship is to provide knowledge and data to enable science-based assessments of environmental sustainability of pharmaceuticals. We are working on three pillars, which I'll shortly explain in the next slides, but the pillars are research and development, manufacturing effluents, and extended environmental assessments. If we go to the next slide. Under the R&D of AI, which stands for Intelligent Pharmaceuticals in Environment, this project is a projection of the potential environmental risk of pharmaceutical substances. The first project ended in 2019, and which was a collaboration between pharma companies, universities, small medium-sized entities, and also one regulators. This project overlooked to develop tools to predict environmental risk early in the development process, also to screen older legacy APIs and environmental risk. The conclusion here was that about 72% of the APIs screened had no effect on the environment as per the European Medicine Agency calculations to determine such a risk. At the moment, a follow-up project, which is called IPI Premier, has been established and started. This project will, over the course of several years, will review the feasibility of greener drug design, development, and hence also greener manufacturing. It will also develop a European-wide environmental risk assessment database to capture already the vast amount but scattered information. Implementation tools for prioritization of legacy APIs will be developed, and also they will actually perform a tailored assessment for about 25 older APIs of concern. Can we go to the next slide? Related to the manufacturing effluent management, the industry has been collaborating on pharmaceuticals production effluent knowledge, expertise, and their risk assessments and management. This was done via Yeah, calling, comparing the data from different companies and manufacturing sites, sharing best practices amongst members of the Eco-Pharmaco Stewardship Task Force, the development of a general guidance document for effluent management assessment, which is to be implemented into ongoing procedures by manufacturers. They also have been collaborating with the Pharmaceutical Supply Chain Initiatives and the AMR Industry Alliance. Can we go to the next slide? In the last pillar and the work towards the environmental risk assessment, industry is proposing to develop the principles of an extended environmental risk assessment. This would mean that the innovator industry would perform 2 years before patent expiry a check and a review on the used amounts of that specific molecule in the countries with the highest capita use, to review new in-house environmental or clinical data, as well as robust scientific publications on environmental properties. And finally, they will update the existing environmental risk assessment, which was originally submitted at time of the registration of the reference product accordingly, but also to publish this updated environmental risk assessment document prior to the loss of exclusivity and to give the generic companies access to the environmental data. In view of the current draft ERA guidance update by the European Medicines Agency, this extended ERA approach would immediately result in a minimization of the duplication of animal tests. Also, it would prevent that multiple generic companies need to invest into the generation of identical environmental risk assessment reports. It will improve the consistency of ERAs because the use of a common template would be suggested, and also updated ERAs are based on actual use and not based on default worst case scenarios. Can we go to the next slide? Before we conclude, let me also highlight the need to have a sustainable product to be produced. With the upcoming and the new regulatory environmental topics to be met and to remain compliant, these requirements are becoming above the already existing regulatory and compliance costs like GMP, variation cost, pharmacovigilance, FMD, etc. So new pricing models would need to be considered, especially for generic medicines, to ensure the product can continue to be produced and supplied to the markets at sustainable prices. If we can go to the next. So we can then conclude, based on the previous slides, that pharmaceuticals in environment is a very complex issue. And pharmaceuticals in environment and antimicrobial resistance are of global concern and require to be addressed as a holistic approach. Scientific and risk-based approaches are needed. No blanket approach solution would be possible. AMR is a priority topic requiring continued attention from all the stakeholders, also the pharmaceutical industry. So we would need, I would call for an extended engagement of pharmaceutical industry towards the AMR Industry Alliance and the work that they are conducting. Industry as stakeholder needs to be very engaged in different aspects of pharmaceuticals and environment. Engagement with policymakers and regulators will need to have a universal vision to address issues like manufacturing effluent and risk and environmental risk assessments. Payers need to be aware that price alone cannot be a winning criteria into tenders. Meeting current and future environmental criteria requires investments into manufacturing operations. Manufacturing needs to continue to be stable, sustainable, even with the increased regulatory requirements, which are affecting the price of a product, with some products being to come at risk of with zero margins. Can we go to the next slide? Okay, we come to the end of the presentation. I would like to thank you for listening and attending this session. If there are questions, would be happy to take a few questions still.